name of God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
But before us, O Lord, Father, as we have continued health, all our works begun, continued, and ended in you, we glorify your holy name, finally by a mercy to the last time, Jesus Christ. Order.
The intro theme number three.
Christ, Lord, Christ, Lord, Christ, Lord, Christ, Lord,
Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Good morning to everyone.
Good morning.
Welcome to celebrate Eucharist, this being the 18th Sunday after Pentecost, according to Proper 21. This act of worship now continues on page 101 of the liturgy book. Please turn to page 101. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Alleluia, alleluia.
Blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Blessed Lord and Father,
we have assembled in your name,
and in fellowship with one another. Enable us by your grace to offer the sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, to proclaim and respond to your holy word. Teach us to pray for your world and your church. Grant that we, confessing our sins, may worthily offer to you our souls and bodies as a living sacrifice, and eat and drink of your spiritual food in this holy sacrament. Amen. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest,
and peace to his people on earth.
Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, you declare your almighty power chiefly in showing mercy and pity. Grant us the fullness of your grace, that we, running to obtain your promises, may become partakers of your heavenly treasure. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please sit for the ministry of the word, the first reading.
1 to 6, verses 20 to 22. The king and Haman went in to feast with Queen Esther. On the second day, as they were drinking wine, the king again said to Esther, "What is your petition, Queen Esther? It shall be granted you. And what is your request? Even to the half of my kingdom, it shall be fulfilled." Then Queen Esther answered, "If I have won your favor, O king, and if it pleases the king, let my life be given me. That is my petition. And the lives of my people. That is my request. For we have been sold, and I and my people, to be destroyed, be killed, and to be annihilated. If we had been sold merely as slaves, men and women, I would have held my peace. But no enemy can compensate for this damage to the king." Then King Ahasuerus said to Queen Esther, "Who is he, and where is he, who has presumed to do this?" Esther said, "Foe and enemy, this wicked Haman." And Haman was terrified before the king and the queen. Then Harbona, one of the eunuchs in attendance of the king, looked at the very gallows that Haman has prepared for Mordecai, whose words saved the king, stands at Haman's house, 50 cubits high. And the king said, "Hang him on that." So they hanged Haman on the gallows that he had prepared for Mordecai. Then the anger of the king abated. Mordecai recorded these things and sent letters to all the Jews who were in all the provinces of the king, Ahasuerus, both near and far, enjoining them that they should keep the 14th day of the month Adar, and also the 15th day of the same month, year by year, as the days on which the Jews gained relief from their enemies, and as the month that has been turned for them from sorrow into gladness, and from mourning into holidays, that they should make them days of fasting and gladness, rather a feasting and gladness, and days for sending gifts of food to one another, and presents to the poor." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm appointed, Psalm 124, Psalm 1, 2, 4. The reading of Psalm 124, beginning at the first verse. If the Lord had not been on our side, let Israel now say,
"If the Lord had not been on our side, when enemies rose up against us,
then would they have swallowed us up alive in their fierce anger towards us.
Then would the waters have overwhelmed us, and the torrent gone over us.
Then would the raging waters have gone right over us.
Blessed be the Lord. He has not given us over to be a prey for their teeth.
We have escaped like a bird from the snare of the fowler. The snare is broken, and we have escaped.
Our help is in the name of the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Second reading is taken from James chapter 5, verses 13 to 20. James chapter 5, verses 13 to 20. Are any among you suffering? They should pray. Are any cheerful? They should sing songs of praise. Are any among you sick? They should call for the elders of the church and have them pray over them, anointing them with oil in the name of the Lord. The prayer of faith will save the sick, and the Lord will raise them up. And anyone who has committed sins will be forgiven. Therefore, confess your sins to one another and pray for one another so that you may be healed. The prayer of the righteous is powerful and effective. Elijah was a human being like us, and he prayed fervently that it might not rain, and for 3 years and 6 months it did not rain on the earth. Then he prayed again, and the heaven gave rain, and the earth yielded its harvest. My brothers and sisters, if any one among you wanders from the truth, and is brought back by another, you should know that whoever brings back a sinner from wandering will save the sinner's soul from death and will cover a multitude of sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We stand for the singing of the gradual hymn, 389, 389.
Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to Christ our Savior.
Mark chapter 9, beginning at the 38th verse. John said to Jesus, "Teacher, we saw someone casting out demons in your name, and we tried to stop him because he was not following us." But Jesus said, "Do not stop him, for no one who does a deed of power in my name will be able soon afterward to speak evil of me. Whoever is not against us is for us. For truly I tell you, whoever gives you a cup of water to drink because you bear the name of Christ will by no means lose the reward. If any of you put a stumbling block before one of these little ones who believe in me, it would be better for you if a great millstone were hung around your neck and you were thrown into the sea. If your hand causes you to stumble, cut it off. It is better for you to enter life maimed than to have two hands and go to hell, to the unquenchable fire. And if your foot causes you to stumble, cut it off. It is better for you to enter life lame than to have 2 feet and be thrown into hell. And if your eyes causes you to stumble, tear it out. It is better for you to enter the kingdom of God with one eye than to have 2 eyes and be thrown into hell, where their worms never die and their fire is never quenched. For everyone will be salted with fire. Salt is good, but if salt has lost its saltiness, how can you season it? Have salt in yourself and be at peace with one another." The Gospel of Christ.
Praise Christ our Lord.
Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and redeemer. Amen. Please be seated. As Christians, one of the things we do every day is pray. During our worship, we pray. When we are leaving, we pray that God will go with us. We pray to ask forgiveness for the mistakes we have made, for understanding when we listen to God's word. We pray for our friends, neighbors, and we thank God for his blessings. We pray at home, school, work, and throughout the week. We say prayers before we eat and before we go to bed. We pray when we feel sad, and we pray when we are happy. We pray when we are scared and when we need help. In some of our prayers, we ask for things. Basically, we pray for all kinds of things. However, there is one reason we pray. We pray to draw closer to God. Prayer is one of the greatest ingredients of our life. Prayer is communicating with our Heavenly Father, who is the source of life and wisdom. In other words, prayer is having a conversation with God. It is the way we listen to Him, keep in touch with Him, fellowship with Him. It is boldly sharing our hearts and minds with Him. It is an action of building our relationship with God and a means of which we sustain it. Prayer assumes that a relationship exists between God and the person, so that the person can believe that God is listening and that God will take the person's petition seriously. That doesn't mean that God will always answer prayers as we ask. However, the more closely our hearts are in line with God's will for us, the more likely we will receive what we ask. In today's reading from the letter of James, the agenda of the day is praying. James calls us to a priority and purpose of prayer in any situation. James says, "Are any among you suffering? They should pray. Are any cheerful? They should sing songs of praise. Are any among you sick?" James gives us a clear indication that praying to God does not mean doing so only when we are in trouble, but also when we feel blessed. In every circumstance, in sickness or health, in joy or sorrow, we ought to pray. Prayers can be done both privately or corporately, meaning individually or in a faith community like we are doing now. There are also different forms of prayer. If you turn to page 406 in the Book of Common Prayers, our catechism identifies for us the different types of prayers. These include prayers as these includes oblation, which is offering ourselves, lives, and work to God. Prayers of thanksgiving, which is giving thanks to God for our many blessings. Prayers of penitence, which is basically confessing our sins, asking for forgiveness with the intention to amend our lives, and there are many other forms of prayers. James also shows us how we should respond as a faith community to those who are sick, both physically and spiritually. James challenges the sick to call on the elders. The priest is seen as a physician, not to the physical condition, but to the soul. One of the things the priest does is administer the sacrament of unction. It includes the anointing of the sick with holy oil, with the aim that God's grace is given for the healing of spirit, mind, and body. Anointing does not only mean that one will be restored physically, but it means that we have come to grips with our illnesses and are at peace with God. James not only shows how the priests or clergy are to respond to the sick, he identifies the role of the church in bringing back someone who has wandered from the faith community. When the member of the church wanders away due to spiritual trouble, it is our responsibility to bring them back. We do this by speaking to them, praying with them, telling them to repent and come back into the family of God. You may wonder why it is that we are called to do this. But remember that Jesus left the 99 sheep to go look for the one that was lost. Confessing one's sins can be dangerous and difficult for some. Sharing our darkest secrets is even worse. But James calls us to confession. I have known persons who have said that they are not confessing their sins to neither a priest or anyone else because they are fearful of what others may think. Such fear leaves the community of God broken instead of whole. However, we remember that it is through prayer that we are healed. Prayer heals the brokenness in our community and the relationship within such community. James tells us this morning that praying in community is important, it is effective and powerful. James uses Elijah to illustrate the effectiveness and powerfulness of prayer. Elijah, at one point in his ministry, prayed that it would not rain, and it did not for 3.5 years. He prayed again that it would rain, and it did. James reminds us that we are like Elijah, and if we pray fervently, seriously, and confidently, like Elijah did, our prayers too can be effective and powerful. A few years ago, at my home parish, St. Paul's, Calicoir, the youth group, as a fundraiser event to travel to Grenada for the Provincial Youth Conference, showed a movie called War Room. It is not a movie about war, as the name implies, but it is rather a movie about the power of prayer. The main characters are a prayer warrior called Miss Clara and Elizabeth, a young lady who has problems with her marriage. Elizabeth has some belief in God, but is not very faithful. In one of the conversations between her and Miss Clara, Elizabeth says that she goes to church sometimes. She adds that she considers herself a spiritual person, not hot and not cold. We can say that she is lukewarm. Miss Clara asks if she wants a cup of coffee and gets up to make it. She returns with the coffee for both of them, hands one to Elizabeth and sits down. Elizabeth tasted the coffee and said, "Miss Clara, do you usually drink your coffee lukewarm?" To which Miss Clara replies, "Mine is hot. God does not like lukewarm." In the movie, Elizabeth says that she does not have time to read the Bible or to pray, as she has a very busy schedule. However, Miss Clara says to her, "But you have time to fight with your husband." In this movie, we see, with Miss Clara's guidance, how Elizabeth wages war against the powers of evil, and by making it a priority to dedicate part of her day to prayer and reading and meditating on God's word, she allows God to change her life and the lives of her husband and child. It is a movie with a lot of messages, and it is worth watching. Sometimes our prayer life can be like that of Elijah and Miss Clara, and then there are times it can reflect that of Elizabeth. While I was preparing this sermon, I mentioned to Archdeacon that I couldn't find the words to say, and his response to me was, "Well, pray about it." The very same thing I am speaking to you about this morning, I myself forgot to do while preparing this sermon. Life places many challenges on us, and we make time for everything else except the one most important thing that God demands of us. And then there are times when we just forget to pray. A good practice is to allot a certain amount of time during the day to spend with God. This can be done early in the morning before you get your day started, during your lunch hour, or late evening before you sleep. I recommend that you do so first thing in the morning, as by evening we are tired from the day's activities. Another practice is, if you forget to pray, or when you think of a loved one or a friend, send up a short prayer to God for them. When you are on the bus heading to and from your destinations, you pray. When someone asks you to pray for them, don't promise to pray later and then forget. Pray right there and then with the person. I know sometimes finding the words isn't easy, but our Lord Himself taught us to pray in the words of the Lord's Prayer. We have scriptures and psalms, and there are many other prayers in the Book of Common Prayer. Even our hymns are used as prayers. Use them to your advantage and approach God's throne as you would with any relationship. A simple, "Forgive me, Lord," or "Protect me, Lord," or "Thank you, Lord," are prayers as well. We don't need to be fancy. So I leave you with the question: is your prayer life like that of Elijah and Miss Clara, hot and effective, or is it like Elizabeth, lukewarm? I pray that we would fashion our lives to that of Elijah and Miss Clara, who prayed fervently and confidently in every situation of their lives. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We stand as we affirm our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed, found on page 106. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The prayers of the people, intercession form H, which begins on page 120. In our prayers, let us remember to pray for all of our prayers and the prayers of the church. Remember to pray for all those persons and things you have been praying for. Let us remember that it is our duty to pray for the peace of the world, to remember all areas where there is unrest of one kind or another. Let us remember to pray for the leaders of this world. Let us remember to pray for the church. Church throughout the world, here in this province of the West Indies, in this diocese of the United Islands, and in this Archdeaconry of St. Lucia. Grant, Almighty God, that all who confess your name will be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Guide the leaders of this land, of all the nations, in the ways of justice and peace, that they may honor one another and serve the common good. Lord, in your mercy, give us all a reverence for the earth as your own creation, that we may use its resources rightly in the service of others and to your honor and glory. Lord, in your mercy, bless all whose lives are closely linked with ours, and grant that we may serve Christ in them and love one another as he loves us. Lord, in your mercy, comfort and heal those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. Give them courage and hope in their troubles, and bring them the joy of your salvation. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We commend to your mercy all who have died, that your will for them may be fulfilled, and we pray that we may share with all your saints in the eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Almighty God, by your Holy Spirit, you have made us one with your saints in heaven and on earth. Grant that in our earthly pilgrimage, we may always be supported by this fellowship of love and prayer, and know ourselves to be surrounded by their witness to your power and mercy. We ask this for the sake of Jesus Christ, in whom all our intercessions are acceptable through the Spirit, and who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God is faithful and just. He'll forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. In a moment of silence, let us examine ourselves before Almighty God. Page 123, 1-3, Form A. Let us therefore confess our sins. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and one another in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have left undone. We are sorry and repent of all our sins. For your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life,
to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen all goodness, and keep in life eternal through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The greeting of peace from C. The kingdom of God is justice, peace, and joy, inspired by the Holy Spirit.
They who dwell in Christ are acceptable to God and approved by others.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us share God's peace with each other in the new COVID-19 norm. Please sit for the reading of the notices, and if you have not yet placed your offerings in the basket, now is a good time so to do.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our Sunday worship at Holy Trinity with St. Mary the Virgin. To all our visitors, a warm welcome to you, especially those worshiping with us via the technology. Hope you have a day filled with much humility and a joyous week. Monday to Friday services in the morning are at 6:30 a.m. Wednesday service, 12 noon, with Holy Eucharist, which is a recording service for airing on Sunday via the following television stations: Choice TV at 7:30 a.m., Calabash TV at 8 a.m., NTN TV at 9 a.m. Parishioners, you are requested to listen to announcements from the Government of St. Lucia on updated or new protocols regarding Sunday service. Also, keep checking your emails for updates from the Archdeacon. I wish to also inform you at this point of the imposition of the continued curfew as follows. Wednesday, 22nd September to Friday, 24th September, from 7 in the evening to 4 in the morning daily, that's Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Saturday, 25th September, from 4 p.m. to Monday, 27 September, 4 a.m. and Monday, 27 September to Thursday, 30th September, the curfew will be from 7 p.m. to 4 a.m. Virtual Sunday school from 2:30 p.m. Choir practice Tuesdays at 5 p.m. until further notice. Virtual confirmation classes are on Saturdays at 2 p.m. And parents and guardians, if you are desirous of your children to participate and to be confirmed, should contact the church office as soon as possible so that you can, your child can commence the confirmation classes. Readings and readers for the month of October are posted at the church's entrances. Readers, do take note to familiarize yourself with the reading for the respective day. Available at the church office are hymnals and service books. Hymnal with music is $75, hymnals are $40, and the service book $45. I have a number of releases. I will start with them. The church in the province of the West Indies, the Provincial Youth Fellowship Weekend, is from October 8th, 9th, and 10th. Under the theme, A Diverse Community of Caribbean Youth Reconnecting to Christ Amidst Adversity. The details of the link, Zoom link, will be made available. As well, the Provincial Youth Weekend will include a diocesan cultural presentation night under the theme, A Diverse Community of Caribbean Youth Reconnecting to Christ Amidst Adversity, and that will be Friday, October 8th, and the times are 6 p.m., 7 p.m., and 8 p.m., depending on where you are at, and the Zoom link is also available. I will recommend that you participate in that. It can also be done if you are interested. You can actually link on to their first book page, CPWI Youth Commission. And as well, they have a games night, and everything is online, people. Games night, fellowship weekend, cultural presentation. You see what COVID has done? Has gotten us to that next level. So that would be the games night is on Saturday, October 9th. And at the same time, 6 p.m. or 7 p.m. or 8 p.m., depending on where you are. And the links are available. You can contact the church office for the link so that your young person can participate, and you as well, I suggest. The St. Lucia Christian Council wishes to provide the following press release, which has been released to everyone, to the media. General elections have taken place and the electorate has spoken. Let us put aside the euphoria of the election campaign and replace it with an atmosphere of sobriety where we can work together to continue the work of nation building. At this time, St. Lucia, the rest of the Caribbean region, and the world are facing one of the worst health crises, at least in recent history, in the form of the COVID-19 pandemic. This has had a serious impact on the economic health of our country, the physical, social, and emotional health of our people. It has disrupted our children's education, our religious and social activities. Moreover, it has put a severe strain on our health services. The fight against this pandemic is not served by name-calling and finger-pointing, but rather by the unified effort of all citizens to comply with the measures put in place by the authorities to combat this disease. The St. Lucia Christian Council calls on all citizens to practice the established protocols of mask wearing, hand sanitizing, and social distancing. proven methods which help to control the spread of this disease. The Sister Lucia Christian Council supports the vaccination drive. Vaccination is not new to St. Lucia. For example, our children have to take particular vaccines in order to enter the education system. These vaccines have saved the lives of many, and adults, may I add, to this day. The Council strongly urges the congregations of its member churches, as well as the citizens, to become vaccinated. This is not only an act of self-preservation, but also an act of sacrifice and love to protect the most vulnerable among us. The Council urges all citizens adhere to the curfews, limiting social activities by the institution of curfews and lockdowns is proven to control the spread of the disease, while at the same time allowing authorities time to conduct contact tracing. The sacrifice and the self-discipline which you exercise will help save lives so that we can attend social gatherings without restriction in the future. The Council calls on all to be their brother's keeper by drawing the attention of authorities to persons who are shut in or the periphery of society who are not able to access vaccinations on their own. The Council urges its member churches to offer their church compounds and institutions as vaccination sites and so enable the authorities to reach as many citizens as possible. The Christian Council commits to sacrifice, prayer, and reflection among the congregations of its member countries, of its member churches, as we work together to fight COVID-19. This is not only about the individual, but more importantly, about the common good. May God continue to guide our leaders and protect our nation. Signed by Ms. Raymond Joseph, the Executive Secretary of the St. Lucia Christian Council. I wish to thank persons who have contributed on behalf of all of us here, the fans. Fans have been donated by individual persons, and we thank you so tremendously. It has made a big difference. I'm sure you would agree. So thank you all who have contributed to the supply of the fans. Sunday, 3rd October 2021 is our Harvest Thanksgiving, and harvest envelopes are available at the offering table in the center aisle. Brothers and sisters, I urge you, please give generously. As our main annual fundraiser, Harvest Bazaar, may not take place, for obvious reasons, may not take place this year. So we have to give generously. We await announcements on new and updated protocols from the government of St. Lucia on the way forward. In the meantime, our Harvest Thanksgiving fundraising activity commences with a sale of a variety of beautiful, healthy plants starting on Wednesday, 22nd September, and continuing every Wednesday and Friday from 10 in the morning to 4:30 p.m. This activity takes place at Holy Trinity Church Road car park. The prices on fruit trees, herbs, orchids, shrubs, and other flowering plants start as low as $5. They're not $5. They start as low as $5. So, plant lovers and your family and friends, please come and get your flowering plants to support this worthwhile venture. As we sojourn daily through intentional discipleship, let us be mindful of our duty to God and duty towards our neighbors. Continue praying for the sick, the shut-in parishioners, persons who requested our prayers, loved ones here and overseas, the unemployed, and all persons affected by COVID-19 pandemic in St. Lucia and around the world. We encourage those who have not been vaccinated to do their Christian and civic duty, being mindful of the multiple effects this already has on a nation. And I must say, it was very disheartening hearing about the number of deaths yesterday. I must admit that, very disheartening. We seek God's protection during the hurricane season. We also pray for his protection on all first responders, frontline workers, educators, learning and health institutions, along with ancillary staff, and also our hospitality and tourism sectors. Continue praying for the islands of the Caribbean and the world with the various challenges being faced presently. We should also keep praying for our government that they, with God's wisdom and guidance, to make right decisions with humility and good judgment in managing the country's resources. For those who recently lost loved ones and those needing our prayers and love at this time, may the Lord console them in their time of need. Our sick and shut-in parishioners and persons requesting our prayers, Doreen Reynolds, Cleota Harris, Isa Charles, Angela St. Rose, Alfonia Stanley, Julietta Joseph, Delise Joseph, Noel Yard, Eric James, Pelia Nice, Mary Jane Lamontine, Cecilia Emmanuel, Rosemary Harris, Audrey Isidore, Marion Maynard, Elaine Lubin, Sylvia Reno Joseph, Joan Ferrari, Francisca and William King, Evelyn Lee, Moses John, Lennox Niles, Ferrier Branford, Thelma John, Eric Branford, Stephen Worrell, Leslie Ann Doss Ramos Fahi, Bradford Felicia, Sanaya Louie, Patricia Pamphil, Juliana Alcide, Gail Jigerson, Durant Phillip, Lydia Ambris, Daphne God, Judith Verity, Evelyn God, Martin Simon, Mollison Walcott, Dean White, Ursula Noel, Mabel Bernadine, Ruby Nicholas, Margaret Rose Dolore, and Rona Smith. We pray and hope that they will feel better soon with our prayers. Birthday and anniversary greetings to persons celebrating today or during the coming week. We extend our birthday greetings to Cleota Harris, Dee Lee, Joycelyn Edwards, Shirley Lewis, Nathan Charles, Kyle Reno, that's Sylvia Reno Joseph's nephew, wishing all of you God's blessings on your special day. Is anybody here present celebrating their birthday?
Let us pray. In the name of God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord God, we join these your children in offering you thanks and praise for sparing their lives for yet another year. We pray, O Father, that as you benefit them the years past, so may continue to be in the years to come, to guard, guide, direct, protect, and to bless them. We ask his mercies, all of the mercies, in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord let light and countenance shine upon you and give you peace, now and forevermore. Amen.
May the good Lord bless you.
anniversaries? Anybody traveling? As usual, if you are traveling, if you are walking down the road, if you are in a company of persons, please ensure that all protocols are strictly observed. Do safeguard yourselves as well as others with God's grace and protection. We will get through these challenges together. People may not reward or thank you for the good things you have done, but when God is your reason for serving, you will receive greater blessings in return. Please keep safe, everyone. Enjoy the rest of your day.
Thank you, Esther, and we wish you the same for today and the rest of this upcoming week. I invite us to stand as we dedicate some vestments for some altar servers and some vessels to be used at the altar in worship, specifically vessels for the incense. Please stand. Let us pray. Our help is in the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of God from this time forth, forever and evermore. Amen. Almighty God, whose only begotten Son received from wise men a gift of incense and made for us the pure oblation foretold by the prophet, we dedicate to your worship this vessel, that our prayers may ascend in your sight as the incense, and the pure oblation of our hearts be proclaimed from farthest east to farthest west. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, before whose heavenly throne your servants minister to you, clothed in white robes, accept these alms and girdles, which we dedicate for the use of the ministers of your church, that serving before your earthly throne, they may worship you in spirit and truth, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. If you have not yet placed your offerings in the offering basket, invite you to do so now as we remain standing to sing the offertory hymn 458, 458. Thank you. We turn to page 126, 1 to 6, for the presentation of the offerings and the Eucharistic prayer. Should use Eucharistic prayer D, found on page 140. You know, page 126. This Eucharist is celebrated to the honor and glory of God. We bring before Almighty God all our cares and concerns for this living, remembering all you've been praying for, all of us for the prayers of the church. We bring especially this global pandemic before Almighty God as we ask Him to lend a hand in alleviating this particular time of stress. Lord, in your mercy. Father, we offer you these gifts that you have given us, this bread, this wine, and this money. With them we offer ourselves, our lives, and our work to become through your Holy Spirit a reasonable, holy, and lively sacrifice. As this bread and wine become the body and blood of Christ, so may we and all your people become channels of your love through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father Almighty, everlasting God. For you are the source of life and light. You made us in your image and call us new life in Jesus Christ, our Lord. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. All glory, praise, and thanksgiving be unto you, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, everlasting God. You created the world and all mankind, and of your tender mercy gave your only Son, Jesus Christ, to take our nature upon him and to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption. He made thereby his own oblation self once offered a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world. And he instituted, and in his holy gospel commanded us to continue, a perpetual memory of his precious death until his coming again. Hear us, O merciful Father, most humbly beseech you, and be pleased to accept, bless, and sanctify these gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that they may be for us the body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. For on the night he was betrayed, he took bread. When he had given thanks to you, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this and eat it. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And after supper, he took the cup of wine. When he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me. In faith, we acclaim you, O Christ.
Dying, you destroyed our death. Rising, you restored our life. Christ Jesus, come in glory.
Now, therefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, we, your servants of all your holy people, having in remembrance the blessed Passion, mighty resurrection, and glorious ascension of your beloved Son, to offer to your divine majesty this bread of eternal life and this cup of everlasting salvation, rendering thanks to you for the wonderful redemption made possible for us in him. And we beseech you, O Father, to accept upon your heavenly altar this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, and to grant that by the merit and death of your Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all the whole church obtain remission of our sins and all of the benefits of his Passion. And we pray that by the power of your Holy Spirit, all who shall be partakers of this Holy Communion may be filled with your grace and heavenly benediction and be numbered in the glorious company of your saints. And here we often present unto you, Lord, ourselves, our souls, and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and lively sacrifice. And although we are unworthy to offer unto you any sacrifice, yet we beseech you to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not being our merits, but pardon our offenses, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory be unto your Father Almighty throughout all ages, world without end. Amen. As our Savior has taught us, so we pray, our Father in heaven, we break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world.
Grant us peace.
The gift of God.
Our souls will feast and be satisfied, and we will sing that song of praise to him.
Thank you.
hymn 593. 593.
577 577.
Thank you. post-communion prayer. It is the second prayer on page 148. Page 148, the second prayer. Let us pray. Eternal God and Heavenly Father, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Send us now into the world in peace and grant the strength and courage to love and serve you and all persons in you with gladness and singleness of heart through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Christ the Good Shepherd, who laid down his life for the sheep, draw you and all who hear his voice to be one within one fold. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you, remain with you now and forevermore.
Amen.
Let me take this opportunity to express our gratitude to the several media houses for carrying this act of worship and providing this public service week by week to this nation. We are truly grateful for this act of generosity. The recessional hymn 480, 480.
Serve the Lord.
Thank you.